So we're looking at an X-Lite system. This is a 50-foot tangential system. This one is installed on a tangent, but they can be installed up to a 2-foot offset. So basically 2 feet back, you could have these on a slight flare. This particular system is installed at 31 inches. They could be installed as low as 27¾ inches. So the 31 inch height, that's measured from the ground surface to the top of the rail. So there's the 31 inch height to the top of the rail. One thing to pay attention to is if this system is installed at 31 inches, make sure that the soil plate is not exposed. That needs to be flush with the ground surface. So we're going to go through the checklist line by line. So to start with, we want to take a look at post number one. Post number one has a slotted hole in it, as opposed to post number three, which just has a standard post hole. So post number one has a slotted opening. Post number three has a standard opening. Now moving around to the front, we need to make sure that the rail is bolted to the posts only at certain locations. So the rail should be bolted to the post at post number one, post number two, not post number three where the slider assembly is. It should be bolted at post number four, not at post number five. And then from here on, post number six on, they should all be bolted to the posts. So back to post number two. We'll go around behind and take a look. This one is really just kind of a double check. But the checklist says to make sure that post number two, that the rail is bolted to the post on the back side of the post. Now, if this post is installed correctly, there is no opening on the front. So that one should be pretty obvious, but it's a good double check for you. Okay, so make sure that post number one, this is a critical piece for this installation. Make sure that the washer and the bolt and the nut are on the front side of this post. You do not want it to be on the back side. If it's on the back side and this post is hit, it will hang up on that bolt and it will not move. So make sure that for post number one, this bolt and this nut are on the front. Moving on down to post number four, same deal. You want to make sure that that's connected on the front side. Post number five, remember the rail is not attached. From post number six on, make sure that the connection is on the front side. So we want to make sure that rail number three and rail number four are connected by these yellow shear bolts. As well as we also want to make sure that rail number two and rail number three are connected by these yellow shear bolts. And make sure those do not get over tightened because they will break, they'll shear off. That's what they're supposed to do, but not during installation. We're gonna take a look at the slider assembly. This is connected together with 8 bolts, 4 on the top, 4 on the bottom. You wanna make sure that those bolts feed through from the back and that the nuts are all in the front side. Another thing you want to look at is this front piece that's been welded on is actually angled slightly inwards. You want to make sure that that is on the trailing end, the end that's away from the impact head. The way you can check to make sure that's correct is to take a look at these arrow cutouts. These arrow cutouts should be pointing, there's one on the front and one on the back. These should both be pointing towards the impact head. We're going to go around behind and take a look at the cable. So the cable connects post 2 at the ground level with post number 3. You want to make sure at the connection, make sure that there is an aluminum cable bracket in between the nut and the actual post. The purpose of this, if this is not there and this nut gets loosened, that cable could drop right out. So that is just there to help hold that cable in place, but it's critical that it be there. The cable, the checklist says that it should be approximately 60 foot-pounds of torque. However, if you don't have a way to measure that, just make sure that it doesn't have more than 1 inch of play. This one's just about right. Finally, just double check that there are no blockouts on post number 1 and post number 2. All the other posts have blockouts, except for these last two. So that's a basic inspection of the X-Lite system. The only other thing you might notice is that normally this would have a reflective chevron on the end of it. We didn't provide those for this test installation, but normally in the field you would have one. It's important that you go through the checklist with each installation, and if you don't understand something, look back through the manual or ask. Thanks for watching.